In this video, we're going to take one of your old baby pictures or an old picture that you have and turn it into a video. And here's an example of one that I did. I turned this baby picture into this video. And we're going to do it with Grok Imagine. Grok is competing with ChatGPT, Manus, Claude, Gemini, all of the big LLMs. Grok comes from XAI and is led by a guy that you probably know who is taking us to Mars and who is the reason why there's a truck like this on the road. His name is Elon Musk. By the way, I love the Cybertruck. I will be my Cybertruck soon. Elon Musk has really been promoting Grok, and there's an AI video feature now within Grok called Grok Imagine. Elon Musk has been on a marketing rampage about this. You can just see that he's promoting Grok Imagine nonstop. What Grok Imagine can do is take any photo that you upload or take a photo that Grok creates and turn it into a video. And it does this extremely quickly within seconds. The first step to do this is you're going to have to download the Grok app. On an iPhone, what this would look like is going to the top of the search bar in your app store and then searching Grok. You'll see that it's the first one all the way at the top. This is what you have to download. I have it, but I do need to update it, so I'm going to click update. Once you have this app downloaded onto your phone, you will click open, and this is what you'll see. At the top, you will see Ask, and you will also see Imagine. Once you click Imagine, you'll start to see all of the other different images that you could turn into videos instantly. And we'll actually try this before uploading our own image. So let's say I liked this dragon photo at the top, and I wanted to turn it into a video and potentially post it on social media. All I would have to do is click it and then click Make Video. You'll see that it starts to load 15%, 27%, 36%, 45%, 54%. And for it to do it this fast, by the way, is incredible. Now, if I liked the video, all I would have to do is click download here, and it will download to my phone, and then I could actually post it. Or I can click up here and I could share it on X or share it on Instagram. You can mute it by clicking the sound button. Now, if I didn't like the video, if it didn't come out the way that I wanted, I could click this down arrow here and I could ask it to redo the video, create a new video, and I could ask it to do it in normal mode, fun mode, spicy, or custom. So if we click fun, it's obviously probably going to maybe do something crazy with the dragon or just make it more dramatic. We'll see what it does. But as you can see, just from the timing, I'm not cutting anything out. These videos are being generated in less than 15 seconds. As I kind of suggested, the dragon is laughing and that's fun mode. We can do spicy, and then you could even insert a custom prompt and tell it maybe for the dragon to do a circle and go flying far away. And we'll test that out to see if it listens to instructions. So here's spicy, and oh my gosh. So with the spicy version, it took the man's shirt off and the dragon's just behind it. With custom, what we can do is we could say, make the dragon fly in a circle and fly away. Again, each of these videos are being generated very, very, very quickly, and they're each about 6 seconds long. So it didn't really listen to the instructions. The model probably still needs to improve when it comes to custom instructions for the videos. And maybe my custom instructions were too complicated. So what I could do is I could say, make the dragon turn green. Just thinking of simpler, a couple word prompts for the custom prompting, at least for now. Okay, so my suspicions were correct. The whole circle, the animations, maybe it flying away was too complicated of a prompt. So try to keep the custom prompt simple, like red to green, maybe specific colors, maybe just one specific movement or one change from the video that it generates for you. If I wanted to save this video again, all I would have to do is click the down arrow. To go back, you just click the top left arrow. And again, these are all the images being created by other users that with just one click, you can make into a video, download, and post. You could also prompt it to create an image first and then turn that image into a video, or do what I promised you at the beginning of this video, which we are about to do. Turn one of the photos that you have, maybe a memory, someone in your family that has passed away, or maybe just a baby picture from your own childhood. You can put it in here and it can create a video. And you could see that it is wanting you to do this because in white here, it says make a video from your photos. When your photos pop up, all you have to do is then click the picture that you want to turn into a video. This is a baby picture of me. There's baby Shanae. And as you can see, it just starts generating video. 12%, 23%, 35%, 48%. Here's the video that it generated, which, I mean, seeing pictures of myself as a baby, it looks pretty spot on. I obviously don't remember what I did immediately after this picture was taken, if I touched the umbrella or whatever. And this poses an interesting question, which I have, which is, how are these AI-generated videos going to affect memory, false memories, or alter certain memories that we may think that we have? And that's just very interesting and a compelling question to think of. So as you could see, though, the quality is pretty much the same as the photo. It does look like me, and it would be something that a baby at that age would do. They would probably start messing with the umbrella. So if I wanted to download it, I could download it. And this is pretty much how easy it is. I've even tried this with multiple people in a photo and it works really well. And I'll show you that. Here's another kid picture, me and my sister. On this one, it has two people that it has to create a video around. And again, it's not the best quality picture. I guess I wasn't in a good mood that day. But I mean, for it to do this in seconds, it's almost creepy. Now, if you wanted to create an image and then a video from your own image, what you could do is just type in whatever you're imagining. So I could say a cartoon frog wearing roller skates that are pink. And once you do that, it'll create it almost instantly. And then I could make a video. Literally, you could imagine anything, have an image created in 3 seconds and a video in less than 20. So go check it out, download the Grok app, and let me know what you think.